Good afternoon, all of you. Do you have any questions from last class? Or otherwise, what we'll do is let me go through it. And meanwhile, I also shared with you 2009 version of IS 10262 and also 2016 version of IS 383. Okay. I will also point out to you what is the difference. And also today I shared with you one assignment. Due date is 25th August. So that involves following the similar procedure and doing the mixed design for M35. Okay. And using the information that is given in the assignment. So let me show you that assignment. And you please make an attempt. And as we progress, if you have any doubts on that, we can actually discuss about it. Okay. So this is the assignment which I sent you this morning. And this is also posted in Moodle. Okay. So a concrete construction project is undertaken with M35 grade. The data for mixed design based on the requirement of durability and construction and availability of materials are as follows. Here some information is given. If any information that you require, if you feel it is missing, you need to make proper assumptions on that. Okay. So exposure condition is severe. Slump is 75 mm. For coarse aggregate, maximum nominal size is 20 mm. For fine aggregate, grading zone is 2. For cement type, ordinary Portland cement of grade 53. Okay, no admixture is necessary. Design the concrete mix as per methodology given in IS 10262 2019. Okay, and I will show you in today's class, before end of today's class, what is the slight difference between the 2009 code and 2019 code, and then it should be easy for you to actually attempt this mixed design problem. Design concrete mix as per the method of IS 10262 2009, following similar steps to that of the illustrative example in Annex A, page numbers are also given, page 16 to 18 of IS 10262 2019. Assume any other required data suitably, okay? And the due date is August 25th. Anyway, please make an attempt. And if you have any doubts or if you have any questions or clarifications required, as you progress, you can bring it to the attention, our attention, so that everybody gets benefited. Okay. So now let's get started. So in yesterday's class, this is where we stopped. Calculation of cement content. Okay. Basically, here we are doing mixed design for M40 grade of concrete, given some conditions. Okay. Let me quickly go through it, because we cannot keep on repeating again and again same stuff. So grade of concrete is M40. That is what we want to actually do the mixed design for. And type of cement OPC, 43 grade, maximum nominal size of a coarse aggregate is 20 mm, minimum cement content 320 kg per meter cube, maximum water cement ratio 0.45, workability is 100 mm, exposure condition severe, method of concrete placing pumping, degree of supervision good, type of aggregate crushed angular aggregate, maximum cement content 450 kg per meter cube. Admixture type super plasticizer is used. Okay. And now coming to the information that is noted from the above data that is given for this mixed design. So cement used is OPC 43 grade. Specific gravity of cement is assumed to be 3.15, and super plasticizer conforming to IS 9103, and specific gravity of coarse aggregate 2.74, specific gravity of fine aggregate 2.74, and water absorption of coarse aggregate 0.5%, water absorption of fine aggregate 1%. And both the aggregates, coarse aggregate as well as fine aggregate, free surface moisture is nil. Okay. And sieve analysis, coarse aggregate is complying or is conforming with table 2 of IS 383, and fine aggregate is actually conforming with grading zone 1 of IS 383. And just now I mentioned to you today, just let me see if somebody is waiting. Okay. So today morning I sent you IS 383 2016 version of code, and there is a slight difference between IS 383 whatever we are referring, that is 1970 version and 2016. The only difference is table 2 in IS 1970 is equal to table 7 of IS 2016 edition of IS 383. Okay, table 2 corresponds to table 7 in 2016. Subsequently, other things, table 3 is going to be table 8, table 4 is going to be table 9, and table 5 is going to be table 10 of 2016. So only the table number is changed, but rest of the things are same, the values, everything. So here the coarse aggregate is conforming with table 2 of IS 383 1970 version, and if you want to write it in terms of 2016 version, it is table 7. Okay, and table 4 of IS 383 1970, which is same as table 9 of IS 383 2016 version. So what I suggest is you please open that, and it is also posted on Moodle. You can see here latest IS 10262/2019 version is posted. 2016 version is IS 383 2016 version is posted here, and also assignment is also posted on Moodle, and same is also sent to you by email. Okay, so now let's proceed further. And target strength for mix proportioning, and IS 10262/2009 version, it is proposing this equation: target compressive strength, or target strength, is equal to characteristic strength plus 1.65 S. S is taken from the table 1 of IS 10262/2009 version. And then target strength for this M40 turns out to be 48.25 Newton per mm square. Okay. And now, what is the difference between 2009 version 2019? Let me show you 2019. You can also open the code book and look at it, because we are asking you to do assignment based on 2019 version. I just want to show you the difference. Everything is self-explanatory. There is not, it's not something very difficult to understand. Okay, so IS 10262/2019 code, it is proposing two equations. One equation is what we already used, and it is also proposing another equation, and is saying you calculate FCK prime, this FCK prime value, you calculate by these two equations, whichever is higher, you adopt it. Okay, here whichever is higher, you take it. So we already know how to do this. That is what is shown in the workout example. Okay, and this one, if you want to also calculate using this equation is there in 2019 version of IS 10262. You require to know what is this x value, and this factor x or this xc is a factor which is based on the grade of concrete, which is given in table 1 of 2019 version of the code. So let me show you that. So this is x value which is given in 2019 version of the code. Okay, so x value you can get from here, table 1 of 2019 version. And table 2 is similar to table 1 of 2009 version. There is no difference. So you need to calculate. If you are following IS 10262 2019 version of code, you need to calculate FCK prime, target compressive strength, using these two equations. Whichever is higher, you need to adopt. That is the only difference. Okay, so this at this in whatever we are discussing in this step, you need to calculate using both equations, and whichever is higher, you need to take it. Okay, now selection of water cement ratio. Selection of water cement ratio, we need to see IS 456 table 5, IS 456 table 5. And then for the exposure condition, here the exposure condition is severe. For exposure condition severe, what is the maximum water cement ratio for reinforced concrete? And that is given in IS 456 table 5. Yesterday I showed you that is 0.45. 0.45 is the ceiling maximum value. And you can actually adopt less than that. And yesterday we already one student even raised on what basis this 0.4 is being adopted. And it is here clearly written, it is based on some experience. And if you are not satisfied with that kind of explanation, IS 10262 2009 version is giving another way of getting this. Okay, so in your assignment problem, you need to make use of that. So let's see that IS 10262 2019 version, it is giving this figure. Let me reduce the magnification so that the figure fits into the screen. So this is that figure. What is this figure? This figure is relationship between water cement ratio and 28 days compressive strength of concrete for concretes of various expected 28 days compressive strength. So how to read this figure? Just now we calculated target compressive strength. If you are following IS 10262 2009 version, you have only one equation. If it is 2019 version, you have two equations. And whichever is higher value from these two equations, you need to adopt it. So that is going to be your target compressive strength. Okay, that is the strength which you are targeting. So now using that value is the target. Once you know target compressive strength, that is what is on this vertical axis. Okay, this 28 day compressive strength, that value you need to take the target value. In our case, it is I told you yesterday class also, I told you to have pen and paper with you. So the target compressive strength is here in yesterday, whatever example we are looking at it, the target compressive strength is 48.25 MPa. Newton per mm square is nothing but MPa, 48.25. So on this vertical axis, we need to read 48.25. And there are three curves here. Which curve I need to select? Here, for that, you need to read whatever description that is given under this figure. Take curve 1. Curve 1 corresponds to OPC 33 grade. Curve 2 corresponds to OPC 43 grade. Curve 3 corresponds to OPC 53 grade. Okay? So read this. In the absence of actual 28 days compressive strength of concrete, curves 1, 2, 3 may be used for OPC 33. OPC 43, OPC 53 respectively. Okay. And for other types of cements, PPC. PPC is nothing but Portland Pozzolana cement. PSC is nothing but Portland slag cement. for these two kind of things, you can make use of curve 2. Okay? You can make use of curve 2. So now, ours here is 43 grade. Our OPC 43 is, in this example, OPC 43. And our target strength is 48.25. So there are online, if you want to precisely find it out, there are online digitizers, okay? Digitizers, you type it, you will get it. And then you can actually grab this picture and then put it in the digitizer. And then you can find exactly what is that value. Otherwise, you can use your eye judgment and then you can read this this value, okay? So 48.25 may be somewhere here. So where it is actually going to intersect, where it is going to actually intersect your curve 2. My eye judgment is saying it is 0.36, something like that. If you want more precise thing, you can use some kind of digitizer and find that value, okay? 0.36, that is what is coming from figure 1 of IAS 10262 2019 code. And what is the value we adopted yesterday? In the example, whatever example that is worked out here, what is the value? This author is suggesting, based on the experience, adopt water cement ratio 0.4. If you want to read from the latest code, it is 0.36. Anyway, here he assumed 0.46. And if you want to precisely follow the new code, then you take it as 0.36, okay, and rework it out. Anyway, once we get all the, I will show you, once we get all the proportions of various materials, we need to do trial mixes. At that time, again, you may need to adjust, okay? So, 0.4 is selected yesterday, okay? And if you want to use new code, I explained to you how to make use of figure 1 of IS 10262 2019 edition of the code, okay? So, once, let's go through the workout here. And whatever water cement ratio that you get here, it should not be more than whatever value that is specified in table 5 of IS 456 2000, maximum water cement ratio that is specified, okay? So here anyway, 0.4 is less than 0.45, so that is accepted. So based on that, again from table 2, maximum water content, Table 2 of IS 383 is giving maximum water content for different aggregate maximum nominal size aggregates of different sizes. Okay, the Table 2 I will show you. Table 2 of IS 383. Sorry. Table 2 of IS 10262. So maximum water content per cubic meter of concrete for nominal maximum size of aggregate. 10, what is the maximum water content? For nominal aggregate size of 20, what is the water content? For 40, what is the water content? It is all given in Table 2. But Table 2 of IS 10262, this is the 2009 version. And this is based on the assumption that aggregates are angular. And also, aggregates, there is a slump. The slump, that is target slump, is between 25 to 50 mm. Okay? And please note that Table 2 of 2009 version of IS 10262 is same as Table 7 of 2019 code. So if you want, I will show you that. Table 7 of sorry, table 2, table 2 of 2001 version of the code is same as table 4 of 2019 version of the code. Okay, so here you can see for 10 mm nominal, I will increase the magnification. For 10 mm 208, and for 20 mm nominal maximum aggregate size is 186, so 40 165. So you open the code book, you will understand. Okay, so now let's go here, this one. So now our slump is actually, for the given problem, so slump, the illustrative example, slump is 100 mm. And the aggregates are angular aggregates. So we need to apply only correction with respect to the slump. Okay? And suppose if the aggregates are also not angular aggregates, some correction is given here. Some correction is given. This is this, whatever is highlighted here, this portion exactly same for 2009 version and 2019 version. So the correction, only table numbers may be different. Okay, so the whatever estimated water can be reduced. Then yesterday we went through this once again. Let me quickly go through it. Can be reduced by approximately 10 kg for subangular aggregates, 20 kg for gravel with some crushed particle, 25 kg for rounded gravel to produce same workability. And for slump, for every 25 mm increase in the slump, increase water percentage by water content by 3%. So this is what code is specifying, IS10262. So same thing is adopted here. Same thing is adopted here. And you can see here, whatever details here given, same thing is adopted. So our slump is 100 mm and it is exceeding 50 mm slump. 2 times 25. So for each 25, 3%. So water content, estimated water content for 100 mm slump is 197 liters. And when you use super plasticizer, water content can be reduced up to 20%. That is also given here. IS10262, that is also given. And that is same for both 2009 version and 2019 version. Okay, water reducing admixtures, if you are using water reducing admixtures or whether you are using super plasticizing admixtures, if you are using water reducing admixtures, water content can be reduced by 5 to 10%, and if it is super plasticizing admixtures, water content can be reduced up to 20%. So in this particular case, we are using super plasticizer. So 20% reduction in the water content can be taken. So whatever water content that you calculated, you can reduce by 20%. Okay? But what this author or whoever worked out this illustrative example, what he's saying is based on his experience, It's above 20% or 20% and above. So he's taking 29%. That is okay. If you don't want to use this, you start with 20%. Okay. So anyway, the details are worked out here with 29% water. So now total water, whatever, after applying all these corrections for this slump as well as for the super plasticizer, final water content is 140 liters. And we also have noted above what is water cement ratio. Based on that, you can calculate cement content. Okay, cement content. And this cement content we need to compare with table 5 of IS456, whatever value that is specified there. And table 5 of IS456 2000 version of the code is specifying some minimum cement content for different exposure conditions. Ours is severe exposure condition, and IS456 table 5 is specifying 320. Whatever we calculated just now, it is 350, so it is okay. Suppose this value 350, instead of 350 we got some value which is less than 320, we need to adopt 320. Minimum 320 we need to add up, and then we need to repeat this step again. We need to go back in the backward direction. We need to go and then recalculate all that previous steps. Okay. Anyway, luckily here, whatever cement content we got is satisfying table 5 of IS 456. Please note that what is this table 5 of IS 456? Why it is giving minimum cement content? It is from durability point of view. It is from durability point of view. Okay. So you got the cement content. This is where exactly we stopped. So you can see almost half an hour or 20 minutes we are discussing about this. So now let's proceed further because we need to complete this in today's class. So we calculated what is the amount of water and what is the amount of cement. And super plasticizer actually is going to be at certain percentage of cement. Okay. So here it is taken as 2%. That we'll see in a while. And what is left out is the aggregates. So that is what is calculated in this step. Proportion of volume of coarse aggregate and fine aggregate content. To do that, we make use of table 3 of IS 10262-2009 code or table 5 of IS 10262-2019 version of code. So this is what that one. Volume of coarse aggregate per unit volume of total aggregates for different zones of fine aggregate for water cement or water cementitious materials ratio of 0.5. So this table 5 of 2019 version is same as table 3 of 2009 version of the code. Okay. So this both the tables are same. Only thing is this title it's given in a more self-explanatory manner. So this table 3 is actually worked out for, it's actually worked out for water cement ratio of 0.5. Table 3 is worked out for 0.5 water cement ratio. So read the title. Volume of coarse aggregate per unit volume of total aggregate. Okay. So it gives you an idea about out of the total volume of the aggregate, what is the percentage, what percent of coarse aggregate should be. And that is going to depend on maximum or nominal maximum size of coarse aggregate. In our case, it is 20 mm. And what is the grading zone of fine aggregate? Our grading zone of fine aggregate is zone 1. In the assignment problem, it is mentioned zone 2. Accordingly, you need to choose the value. Okay. So in our case, volume of coarse aggregate per unit volume of total aggregate is 0.6. That means 60% of coarse aggregate should be there. But this table is assuming water cement ratio of 0.5. But what is our water cement ratio? What is our water cement ratio? Our water cement ratio, we are assuming it to be 0.4. So some correction has to be applied. Okay. So from table 3, read this one. From table 3, volume of coarse aggregate corresponding to 20 mm size aggregate and fine aggregate zone 1 for water cement ratio of 0.5. And what is the value that is given in the table? What is that value which we read? It is 0.6. But that is for water cement ratio of 0.5. Our water cement ratio is 0.4. So therefore, volume of coarse aggregate, volume of coarse aggregate is required to be increased to decrease fine aggregate content. So some correction has to be applied. Okay. What is that correction? What is that correction? That correction is given here. You need to increase or you need to change the whatever value of this table is giving some value. Here it is 0.6. This value, some correction has to be applied. If this water content, here it is 0.4. Actually, this table is worked out for 0.5. So there is a difference. No, here our water content is 0.1 less water cement ratio is 0.1 less than what this table is actually worked out for. So we need to apply correction for that. How to get that correction? The correction is you just note it on your paper, whatever pen and paper I ask you to have with you. You note down there the rate. The correction is minus or plus 0.01 for every plus or minus 0.05 change in the water cement ratio. So how much is the change in the water cement ratio? The table is giving for 0.5. Our water cement ratio is 0.4. So it is actually minus 0.1. And minus 0.1, if it is minus 0.05, it is plus 0.01. If it is minus 0.1, then it's going to be plus 0.02. Okay, so that is what is mentioned here. Okay, as the water cement ratio is lowered by 0.1, proportion of volume of coarse aggregate has to be increased or is increased by 0.02. That is actually calculated from here. And this is same for 2009 version of code or 2019 version of code. So in your assignment problem, you need to work out in this fashion. Okay, so this 0.6, we need to apply correction on that. What is that correction? That correction is this one. Therefore, corrected proportion of volume of coarse aggregate for water cement ratio of 0.4 is, this is positive number. So whatever 0.6 is there, to that we need to add this 0.02. So total coarse aggregate proportion is going to be 0.62. Okay, so points out of total aggregate, 0.62 should be the proportion of coarse aggregate. And what should be the proportion of fine aggregate? You can back calculate. But before that, some other correction we need to apply. Please note that all this, whatever we have done so far, till to this point where we got 0.62, that is assuming the concrete is like, you know, we have not used any condition on that. Okay, and code is also saying for pumpable concrete these values should be reduced by 10%. If the this is for concrete which is not which is placed without pump. If you are using pump to place this concrete, then these values should be reduced by 10%. This is also given in code book. Okay, this information is given in code book here. For more, page 3 of 2009 version of the code, similar paragraph you will find it in 2019 version of the code. For more workable concrete mixes, which is sometimes required when placement is by pump or when concrete is required to be worked around the congested reinforcing steel, it may be desirable to reduce the estimated coarse aggregate content. So the basic idea is so that the concrete flows into the congested areas, we are reducing the coarse aggregate content by 10%. And also when you are using the pump. Okay, so since here it is mentioned method of concrete placing is pumping, we can reduce coarse aggregate content by 10%. 10% of what? Whatever value we got here, 0.6, you can reduce it by 10%. So 0.6 multiplied by 0.9. So this is going to be our coarse aggregate content. And what about fine aggregate? 1 minus, this is 0.56 is out of the total aggregate. What is the proportion of coarse aggregate? And if you want fine aggregate, 1 minus that is going to be a fine aggregate. Okay. So now you got some information about water content, you got some information about cement, you got some information about proportion of coarse aggregate, you got some information about proportion of fine aggregate. So now let's go and give the details or note down the details. Let's assume total volume of concrete is 1 m³. In the total volume of concrete, what is volume of cement? You already calculated. You already calculated what is the mass of cement. Mass of cement is 350 kg per meter cube. And but here we want the volume of cement. And you need to go to your basics. So mass divided by specific gravity multiplied by 1000. 1000 is nothing but density of water. So what is volume? Mass divided by mass density. Mass divided by mass density is going to give you volume. So that formula is applied here. Mass of cement is known. Specific gravity of cement you already noted. And this 1000 is density of water. So finally, this is the volume of cement. Basically, whatever weight you got, 350 kg per meter cube, you are converting into volume. Similarly, volume of water. You got 140 liters or 140 kgs. 140 divided by specific gravity of water is 1 multiplied by 1000. When I say multiplied by 1000, it is in the denominator. Okay? So you got volume of water. So volume of concrete is 1 m³. In that volume of concrete, cement volume is this much. Volume of water is this much. And what about the some more product is there? What is that? Superplasticizer. Superplasticizer is at the rate of 2% of mass of cementitious materials. Please note that this superplasticizer, how this 2%? Who specifies this? Usually manufacturer of this superplasticizer is going to give you that information. How much percentage of this superplasticizer I need to add? So that is taken from there. So with this 2%, at the rate of 2% by mass of cementitious material, if that information is given, or you can suitably assume if that information is not given, you know what is the mass of cement, you can easily find what is the mass of cement chemical admixture or superplasticizer. What is mass of cement? 350 kg. What is 2% of that? It is going to be 7 kg. Okay, so volume of this superplasticizer is going to be mass of superplasticizer divided by specific gravity of superplasticizer multiplied by 1000, in the sense of denominator. Okay, so you got the volume of the superplasticizer. So out of total volume, 1 m³, volume of cement is known, volume of water is calculated, volume of superplasticizer is calculated. So whatever, what is left out? That is nothing but your volume of aggregates, coarse aggregate plus fine aggregate put together. So that is what is calculated. And once you have this volume, in this volume, what is the proportion of coarse aggregate? What is the proportion of fine aggregate? That is based on this information. Here it is 0.56, 0.44. So you multiply that way, okay? So here, instead of volume, mass is calculated. Once you know this volume, in this 0.56, 0.56 is going to be mass of coarse aggregate, 0.44 is going to be mass of fine aggregate. So this multiplied by 0.56 is going to give mass of volume of coarse aggregate. This multiplied by 0.44 is going to give you volume of fine aggregate, okay? So once you know volume of fine aggregate, volume of coarse aggregate and volume of fine aggregate, you can easily calculate multiplying with the specific gravity and density of water, you are going to get what is the mass of coarse aggregate, what is the mass of fine aggregate. Okay, so finally prescription. What is the prescription? This is what you are going to tell. This is what finally from your calculation. What is the mass of cement per meter cube of concrete? What is the mass of water per meter cube of the concrete? What is the fine aggregate mass per meter cube of concrete, coarse aggregate per meter cube of concrete, chemical admixture, and water cement ratio has to be 0.4. Okay. And while getting this, please note that we assumed aggregates to be fully saturated surface wet. Suppose aggregates absorb some moisture. Aggregate absorbs some moisture. How to do that? How to do that? That is given in 2019 version of code. An illustrative example is given in 2019 version of code. Okay. To apply corrections for that water absorption by the coarse aggregate, by the fine aggregate. So here, adjustment on water, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate. Okay. So that adjustment is given here. You can go through it. Okay. I have given enough explanation. You can go through that. Okay. So if the aggregates are absorbing some water, what we need to do is we need to add additional water. And if aggregates are not surface dry, we need to deduct some water. So that is what is mentioned here. Aggregate should be used in saturated surface dry condition. If otherwise, when computing the requirement of mixing water, allowance shall be made for free or surface moisture contributed by fine and coarse aggregates. Okay. On the other hand, if the aggregates are dry and the amount of mixing water should be increased by an amount equal to the moisture likely to be absorbed by the aggregates. Suppose the aggregates are dry and they are not saturated. When you add water, what is going to happen? Aggregate is going to absorb some water. So that how much it's going to absorb, that you need to add additional water. Okay. So necessary adjustments are also required. Please note that whatever mass of fine aggregate we calculated here, whatever mass of coarse aggregate we calculated here, they are based on the assumption that aggregates are fully saturated and surface wet. Suppose the aggregates are absorbing water, aggregates are not fully saturated, or aggregates have some on the surface some water is there, we need to apply some correction. So necessary adjustments are also required to be made in the mass of the aggregates. So these are based on surface dry, fully saturated. If they are not, even this mass, we need to apply some correction. Okay, how to apply that correction? Everything it is given in this 2019 version of the code. It's easy to follow. So I suggest you read yourself and try to complete assignment problem. Okay. So mixed proportions after adjustment for dry aggregates. For the example, there is also one example in 2019 version of the code. Annexure A is having one example. You follow that example and try to complete assignment problem. Okay. So after applying all these corrections, anyway, let me complete this. Surface water and percent water absorption of aggregate shall be determined according to IS 2386. Anyway, here that information is directly assumed. And if you want to really find it out for a given aggregate, how to get this, you need to follow this code and do some testing. Okay. So now we got this various proportions, or how much each of these quantities have to be there in 1 meter cube of concrete. Then what we need to do? You prepare a concrete mix using this, and then after that, slump shall be measured and water content and dosage of admixture shall be adjusted for achieving required slump based on trial if required. Please note that whatever calculations we did, that is all based on the information that is given. Sometimes when we use these proportions and mix, whatever slump we are targeting, we may not achieve or sometimes some correction may be required. So you need to, whatever calculations based on that you mix, and you get the concrete and measure the slump, and then also water content and dosage of admixture can be adjusted depending on whether you are getting whatever slump you wanted. Suppose here we want 100 mm slump. Based on that only we calculated, we did all these calculations. But when I actually mix, we may sometimes, because of some reason, if you are not getting 100 mm slump, or if you are getting too much 150 mm slump, then you can do some trial and error and adjust the water content and dosage of admixture. Okay, the mix proportions shall be reworked out. The mix proportions shall be reworked for the actual water content and checked for durability requirements. So now you did some trial and error. You did some trial and error and you got some water content. Okay. And then based on that water content, you need to go back and rework out everything. And again, you have to get a new or corrected values of this. Okay. And then also you need to check from durability consideration, table 5 of IS 456, whether minimum cement content is maintained or not. Okay. So that is the how you proceed. And once you actually did all this, once you finalized, then you need to do two more trials of varying water cement ratio by 10%. Okay, shall be carried out, and a graph between the three water cement ratios. So here one water cement ratio, after reworking out everything, water cement ratio we are getting. Two more trials we are doing, varying 10%, plus or minus 10%. And we got three water contents for each of these three water contents. And then corresponding strength, you plot it, shall be plotted to work out mixed proportion for a given target strength for field trials. Okay. And also durability requirement shall be met. So this is a mix. This is what design mix process, entire process. But as a part of our assignment, as a part of our this one, we stop here. You get the proportions of various quantities. You stop there. This is all lab work. Okay. These 2 points are lab work. Once you get these values, you need to go to lab and prepare the mix and find out slump, and then do trials and other things. And then finally, you, based on these trials and other things, you can give some value. But that is all lab work. Okay, we are not focusing on these 2 points. So at this stage, we can stop here. How to get these proportions, okay? So with this, I'll stop. Any questions or comments, you let me know. So you need to go and see this things, whatever I uploaded, 2019 version of the code, there, as I mentioned, there is not much difference except some two target strength equations are given in 2019 version of the code. Whichever gives higher, you need to make use of it. And also an additional figure is there to help you out with the water cement ratio. And One more table is given for in the example, the details, how to adjust for water, that information is given. You can go through that. Okay, so I'll stop here, and if you have any questions, you let me know. Professor Amlan, you want to add something?
Yeah, let me just point out, see, initially this mixed design may appear confusing. So you have to appreciate that an engineered material, which is an engineered construction material, concrete, is being produced from natural sources. And hence, the calculations are not straightforward. There will be, as it is being repeatedly mentioned, that there will be trial and error procedure to come up with a final mixed design. You may also see that there are different requirements for strength, for durability, for workability, and then you have to select whichever is the best out of the out of these requirements. Hence, see, whenever you see some value like minimum cement content or maximum water to cement ratio, you may not have to pick them exactly because those are the limits. You have to adjust to meet the other considerations also. Okay. Okay, one more point I wish to mention, that you will be seeing that we are juggling between mass and volume. It may be initially confusing, why are we doing so? See, whenever we are making concrete, the contractor is interested to know how much concrete is being produced in terms of volume. However, in the mixed design, the selections are based on weights or masses. And hence, we have to switch between mass and volume through the relationship of the specific gravity. This also you have to be careful. And the final point what I wish to mention is that there was an important relationship where we are making sure that the full volume of 1 meter cube of concrete is being filled up by materials. That's where we are using what is called the particle packing theory, that it has to be a dense material with all the constituents put in it. Okay. Okay. I think any questions from your side?
Anyway, students, what I suggest is you please take the assignment seriously and try to work it out. And if you have any questions related to this assignment and you feel satisfied, okay, you feel satisfied that you know how to do mixed design. Okay. Any other questions?
Sir.
Yes, I'm waiting for you. Okay. Yuvraj.
Sir, why in same exposure condition the grade of RCC and PCC are different, sir? Sir, means if we are using RCC, then we are using higher grade cement, and if you are using PCC, we are using lower grade cement. Why, sir?
Sir, Yuvraj, we are not using higher grade cement. We are this minimum.
Sir, I mean concrete.
Huh?
Sir, I mean concrete, sir. By mistake, I said cement.
No, because durability consideration, no, we have to protect the steel.
No, I would just add, see, plain concrete is typically used for maybe making a like a base mat. Plain concrete is not used for structural application. It is only used for some as a filler material. And hence, the restrictions placed on reinforced concrete are relaxed for plain concrete. Okay, they are not same, just to make plain concrete more economical than reinforced concrete.
One more thing, this plain concrete usually, you know, suppose you are casting some foundations. Foundation, where it's going to rest? It's going to rest on soil. So that's we cannot just simply put the main concrete on the soil. We are going to prepare a bed. That for that PCC bed will be there. So we are going to level the ground and put some plain concrete, and then over that we are going to put this RCC. Okay. So for that kind of purpose, we will be using this plain concrete. Any other questions? Anyway, we have a break in the sense we have Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, we don't have class. So what I suggest is you please take some time and then you please take the assignment problem seriously and keep 10262 2019 version and 9 version of the code. And whatever explanation that I have given you, you please see all the tables. And I expect you to complete assignment, even though due date is August 25th, I expect you to complete by next class. And if you have any questions, you come back to me. Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Okay.